The Corsair H115i ELITE Capellix. Is it just me or are these titles getting a little bit confusing nowadays? Well, if they are, I'll help break it down for you. The 115 on the cooler lineup refers to Corsair's 280mm radiator solutions, where the 100 refers to 240mm, for example, and the 150 refers to a 360mm solution. The ELITE Capellix, however, differs further from other models with two 140mm fans. These fans are typically quieter than other 140mm solutions, and you may notice that these fans look very similar to that of the H115i RGB Platinum coolers fans as well, and that is because they're essentially identical. However, after the 115 comes the i, and this stands for iCue. This is Corsair's software utility, and here you can change the colors of the RGB fans, RGB pump head, and even change the fan operation mode for the Capellix model with three different settings. That is balance, default mode, quiet, and extreme. Finally, however, the H stands for hydro, that is water. Now you may wonder why I always want to look at the 280mm versions, which are my personal favorites, even over the 360mm solutions. I mean, after all, bigger is certainly better, right? Well, the difference between these two actually has to do with 140mm fans versus 120mm fans, as the bigger numbers of 150 versus 115, for example, certainly doesn't make me feel insecure. I mean, I've got an ex-wife for that. Basically, I know what I want when it comes to a CPU water cooler. Though, is the H115i ELITE Capellix what I really want over the H115i RGB Platinum? And the short answer is, I still prefer the RGB Platinum H115i. And we'll go over the numbers here to explain that further. Basically, out of the box, the default fan profiles are quieter on the Platinum. Even though the temperatures are better on the ELITE, I do actually prefer lower noise. Since my computers are usually desk mounted and are quite close to my ears, I decided to test this over four different CPU setups, and the numbers are very consistent. These 280mm coolers do a very good job, even that over the flagship air coolers out there on the market. Though Corsair says the ELITE Capellix has a new pump design, and in testing it performed well, and the new Capellix LEDs, there is 33 of them by the way, are essentially smaller, brighter, and more efficient RGB LEDs that do a great job of pushing out the bling. You even get a swappable clear plate if you want more RGB to shine through. However, the ML140mm fans are still what looks to be identical to the H115i RGB Platinum. And as I said before, it performs similar to the point where it's more a fan profile trade-off, and I personally think Corsair absolutely nailed it with the H115i RGB Platinum fan curve profile over the new ELITE Capellix series. I wouldn't change it, it's perfect, and it's my go-to recommendation for someone who wants a premium cooler and can afford the extra bling to cool down a high-end CPU. Though at $169 US versus $189, and in Australia $244 versus $259, the ELITE series does cost more, and this is another reason why I do prefer the RGB Platinum. However, that said, you do get with the ELITE Capellix the Commander Core RGB control box. This allows you to connect 6 PWM fans and 6 Corsair RGB connections, which then connects to your computer via USB 2 front out. In the software, you can link the RGB to other Corsair products and have syncing effects. There is also multi-layers of RGB that you can add, and to quite simply put it, the iCue software is very polished and works extremely well for customization. When it comes to RGB, however, I do like to set it to the temperature setting, so it does more than just aesthetics, it's actually indicating how hot my CPU is getting. I think this is a really good thing if you're overclocking like me and you're constantly being conscious of overheating. Also included in the box is the AMD and Intel mounting brackets, so this will mount to either platforms with these, including AM4 and Threadripper, and even though it doesn't say it on the box, X58 LGA 1366. It will also mount to that as well. Clearance on practically any motherboard is also a big plus for all-in-one water coolers. Some air coolers, for instance, will have troubles mounting on certain motherboards, especially if the VRM component area is beefy. I'm yet to have this problem on any Corsair water cooler that has come through here, and I've tried a lot of motherboards. And also lastly, Corsair do stand behind their water coolers, offering a 5-year warranty on the ELITE Capellix. Though ultimately, it's now conclusion time, and if you like better temps at the cost of more noise, and you like more RGB, and the included command controller box is for you, then this cooler is a solid option. Though for me personally, it costs more than the H115i RGB Platinum, which is still my favorite go-to cooler on the premium side of things. And when I was sent one in for a review a while ago, I absolutely loved it. And since then, I bought two more for my personal PC and benchmarking setups. The balance of temps, noise, and aesthetics really struck a chord with me personally. Anyway, if you guys enjoyed this one, then be sure to hit that like button for us. Also, let us know in the comments section below what you're sporting as a cooler, whether it's a budget AliExpress snowman, which is really good value for money, or if you want to go on the premium side, what water cooling or air cooling solutions are you rocking? Love reading your thoughts and opinions as always. And with that aside, if you stayed this far and you're enjoying that content, you're not yet subbed, be sure to hit that sub button, ring that bell to get the content as soon as it drops here at Tech Yes City. And I'll catch you in the next tech video very soon. Peace out for now. Bye.